I would like to welcome you again in our tutorial. It's our another video program. In the last program, we discussed about what is our program, and very basically, very brief introduction. We discussed about what is our console and what is our editor, what we will do with our editor and what we will get from our console. In the last video, we also discussed about very basic mathematical operation and the very basic thing of how we can assign value with the variables. So today we will discuss how we can import data and how correlation and regression analysis will be done in our program. Okay, let's start with how we can import data. There are several methods to import data to the R program. Here we will import data from txt file. I will give a name of the data. I will give BP is the short form of blood pressure. Then read.table, then file.judge, then I will provide the header information. It is true. Here we need to take care header is a command and true is a variable. That's why true need to be in all caps lock capital form. So instead of true, you can just write T. So what is the difference between true and false? In data set, what I am going to import, I'm going to import have the very first line of a variable name. They are not observation, they are not data, they are just name of the variable. If you have a data set which immediately start with the data with observation, then in this case you need to write here false instead of true. Okay, so for separators I have tab delimited. I will close it and I will run it. Oh, here is mistake. It's a comma, not period. Okay, run it. Then it will get this dialog box. Then you will choose the file from your window selection. Then it will, here you can see your file has been imported. Now we have to make sure what kind of the data we imported and how we can do how we can see this data. Okay, the very simple way, you just can write the name of the data set. Here we have data set name BP blood pressure and just run it. It will get the view here, this view x1, x2 and x3. We have three variables and 11 observations. Alternatively, if you provide str with variable name BP, then it will get another looks here. Here's the data frame with 11 observations and 3 variables. It is same. Okay, now we imported data and we just view what data is this. And now let's check, see some summary, some statistics of our data. For that, just write summary and give your data name BP. You will get the summary here. Here is mean, first quartile, median, mean, third quartile and maximum value. Alternatively, you can also do summary of every variables, for example, we have x1, we have to provide location also in case x1, then you will get same result in different form with just command to provide summary statistics, descriptive statistics of x1 variable. Please note here, we provide here BP with dollar sign before name of the variables. It means we are saying we want to know summary of x1 variable, and x1 variable is located in BP file. So if you give just the x1, then you see you will get the result here also. It's the same. So we can also assign our x1, our x2, our x3 from here. We can get here we have very simple data set x1, x2 and x3, but in case in many cases in the real scenario we may have various variables, not few. So in this case you can say just names and provide the variable your data set, and it will print out here the name of the variable. For the other data set, I prefer to copy it here for the further use. And another thing to be noted here, in the R program, if you start anything with the asterisk, it will not read it. This line is a command, because after the after this has it understands it is a description, not a command. Okay, now let's see about correlation. For the correlation, you can write this as I mentioned has after the has. As you say correlation, then it means we are going to do correlation. It will not read. For example, you can see here, if you run this line, nothing, just same line. But if you remove this and run it, it will say here, error unexpected string constant. It cannot read, but if you put hashtag, then it will not read. For correlation, you can, if you want just a correlation coefficient, you can just write cor command and x1 and x2. You will get result here. Similarly, you can have correlation coefficient of x1 and x2. Similarly, correlation of x2 and x3. We can run both line at once. You will get result here, correlation coefficient. But another interesting way, instead of just getting single correlation coefficient, we can also produce correlation matrix in the matrix form. It is more convenient to use as a matrix form. You can write correlation and just start with age matrix, and from where you are getting, that is BP, just close it and run it. Here you will get very beautiful matrix form. It is exactly the same. X1 and X2, they are the same values, so perfectly correlated, 100%. And X1 and X2, 97%. Here you can say X1 and X2, 97. It's the same value. And X1 and X3, X1 and X3, where is X1 and X3? Oh, we get same value. Okay, we will say they have the same value. It is in the matrix form. Let's see, X1 and X3 here. It's 9705. 9705 is the same value. In this way, you can also make a correlation. Okay, let's start with regression. To start with the regression, we will see here with the different models from our available data. So I will start with the model 1. Just you can write any name, no problem. I will assign model 1 is we have a linear model, and we are going to see x1 with x2, and from where it is coming, that is data coming from BP. Before this, we have to know what is x1 and x2, isn't it? So here, x1 is systolic blood pressure, and x2 is age in year, and x3 is weight in pound. So let's see what is the relation between age and systolic pressure. Just I wrote model, I will run it. Okay, model is good. Now to see a model, you can just type model one. If you have another name, no problem, you can type that name. You will get here intercept and the coefficient ratio. But if you want to see more results, you can type summary of model 1, then you will see many more, starting from minimum value, first quartile, medium, third quartile, maximum value, and here coefficients. You can see intercept and x2, they are the coefficient estimates. We say intercept and coefficient of x2, standard error, t-value, and probability with significant. If so, they are highly significant. And you can see here residual standard error, degree of freedom 9 here, and multiple r square 0.957. it means quite good. You can see adjusted r square, f statistics, and degree of freedom, p-value, everything you can find here. Okay, let's do with another model, model 2. Here's a similar process. In the model 2, we are going to add another variable x3 and data coming from BP, and we will do summary of model 2. Okay, you run it, you will get result here. But if you see every statistic is same, if you see here significance is a significant level, they are going down. It depends on your data. Sometimes significant goes off if you add more variables. Sometimes we lose our goodness of model if you add more. In our case, in this data set, The first simple model is stronger than the second model. So how can we see, how can we know which model is better? Of course, we can predict more, and with more confidence, it will be the better. Sometimes we can see difference. Of course, there will be the difference between two models if you pick more or if you drop the variables and the models. Then in this case, to know significance, to know whether dropping variables or adding new variables are significant or not, you can check from ANOVA of model 1 and model 2. You will see the result here. You can see model 1 and model 2 are significantly different. In this way, you can choose a model with the different alternative models which will fit more. Thank you for watching this video. We will come with another videos with the different other topics. For until that, thank you and goodbye. But before that, please don't forget to like our video in YouTube and don't forget to subscribe us. Thank you very much. See you again.